So, viewers, we want to thank God that you're joining us once again. You're listening from this thing I'm saying that it's not because of who we are, it's because of who Jesus is. It's not because of anything we've done, it's because of what he has done. It's not because of anything we could have ever done, it's because of what he did. He died for you on the cross. He died for me on the cross. We are forgiven. We are set free. We are redeemed. He cared to know our names. He is God above all. He is God. He is God alone. Want to read our scripture? I want to welcome you, our YouTube viewers, that you may join us together as we read the Word of God. And as we are going to hear what the Lord is telling us today, what He has prepared for us, let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you because of your goodness. Thank you because of what you've done on the cross. You died for me. You died for us. You died because of our sins. Lord, this is amazing grace. This is amazing love. Thank you, Jesus, King of all the glory. As you speak to us today, help us to remember that it is because of who you are that we are who we are. Blessed be your name, exalted be your name. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Today I would like us to read from the book of Acts, chapter number 10. We read around from verse 34 to 43. Let me read, and I hope you're reading together with me. Then Peter opened his mouth and said, "In truth I perceive that God shows no partiality, but in every nation whoever fears him and works righteousness is accepted by him." And you see, this is a very interesting portion of the scripture where Cornelius was given this vision, and Peter came, and he was about to even reject the mission of God because he was saying, "Oh no, I'll not eat things that are not clean. I am a Jew, and we don't take such things," that he was being shown on the during the vision. But this time, when he came and God gave him this message, we realized that he realized that God had poured his Holy Spirit to the Gentiles, and he said, "Now indeed I know that God shows no partiality." He says that whoever fears him, whoever works righteousness is accepted by him. And this is my message. This is God's message for you today. Despite of who or where or in which place you are or in which nation you are or in which state you are, God does not show us any partiality. He loves us the way we are. Why? Because it is because of who he is. God is love. God is merciful. God is good. God is marvelous. God is awesome. He shows no partiality. And therefore, even in the giftings of God, the book of the book of First Corinthians, the book of Romans, it says 11:29, that the gifts of God, they are irrevocable. They are without repentance. Because when God gives us his gift, he shows no partiality. These gifts can be given to anyone. Why? Because God looks for them that fear him. Actually, the book of Psalms 25 says that the covenant, God makes his covenant with those who love him, those who fear him. And he says those are the people to whom he reveals his secret. Therefore, I want to remind you today, my viewer, wherever you are, God shows no partiality. He receives all people from whichever region they are in. He is able to do all things because he is omnipotent, he is omnipresent, he is God above all. He does not require the counsel of any man. The Bible says that his wisdom, if you read in Isaiah 40, the Bible says his wisdom is unsearchable. We serve such a great God. He is not like people here on earth when we are. We hear stories of people when they are looking for jobs, and because they are known to this person or to this person, they are given the job, or they are given an opportunity to do something, but it is not so with our God. Our God shows no partiality. He selects men from everywhere, from any nation, from any tribe, from any place, from whichever region you are in. Our God shows no partiality. So what does he require? For all of us, he requires people who fear him and works righteousness. And I want to remind you what Peter here is saying. If I continue with verse 36, it's saying, the word which God sent to the children of Israel, preaching peace through Jesus Christ, he is Lord of all. That word you know, which was proclaimed throughout all Judea and began from Galilee after the baptism which John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, and who went out doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. You can see what God did for all of us, that he was able to send his only begotten Son to come and die for us because we were lost in our sin. Why? Because God shows no partiality. He sent, he anointed Jesus with the Holy Spirit. And when he anointed him, he went doing good and healing all the people who were oppressed by the evil one, because God was with him. And that is why even during this time, Peter is telling people around there who are Gentiles. Remember, the Jews were not supposed to associate with the Gentiles. They were considered unclean. But here God is coming and telling Peter, don't call what I have called clean unclean. And he is telling Peter, these are my chosen people. I love them. And so God in this way shows that he shows no partiality. Therefore, never think in your life that you are disadvantaged. Never think that God hates you. Never think that God does not think about you. No, God shows no partiality to anyone. God is able to give us anything that we desire. Actually, the Bible says, delight yourself in the Lord. So these are the things that we require to realize, that our God is so loving. And that's why he gave his only begotten Son, because he shows no partiality. His desire is that we can all become saved. He says he does not delight in the death of a sinner. And therefore, wherever you are, whatever you are doing, whichever situation you are facing, whatever temptation you could be going through, even if you are not born again, today I want to remind you that God does not reduce his love because you're not born again. No, God, today I'm calling you to love him. He loves you unconditionally. That's why he died for you. So if you're passing through difficult times, if you're passing through challenges in your life, if you're seeing like this life is drawing a lot of challenges to you, can you be reminded our God is good over all things? He shows no partiality. He sent a message to the children of Israel that he is the Lord of all. Actually, the Bible says in Isaiah chapter number 40, that have you not heard? Have you not heard that the Lord is God? He alone is God. It is the Lord who is declaring this. Therefore, be reminded today that God is not a God of favorism. No. God does not show favoritism to anyone. He loves us the way we are. He requires us to just fear him. And fearing God means we reverence him. We have a respect for God. We have a love for God. We have that aspect of having reverence for God, because he is the creator of everything. Therefore, today, if you've been feeling like God is not on your side, can you be reminded today, God shows no partiality. And as we end this one, it is saying that Peter is saying, we were witnesses of all these things which he did in the land to the Jews and in Jerusalem, whom they killed or hanging on a tree. Him God raised up on the third day and showed him openly, not to the people, but to witness, to the witnesses chosen by God, even to us who ate and drank with him after he saw he arose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and testify that it is he who was ordained by God to judge the living and the dead. To him all the prophets witnessed that through his name Whoever believes in him will receive the remission of sin. Therefore, as we end this session for today, I want to encourage you, no one is too sinful to be forgiven. All our sins were taken by the blood of Jesus who hung. They hanged him on a cross, all because God did not favor anyone. God loves us the way we are. God loves you if you are a man, if you are a woman, if you are lame, if you are blind, whoever you are, wherever you are, the way you are, God loves you because he does not show any partiality. He loves you the way you are. Therefore, whoever will believe in this name of God, of Jesus, who was sent by God, will be remitted. His sins will be remitted. His sins will be carried away. His sins will be washed as a snow. They'll be as white as snow because God loves us the way we are. Therefore, today you could be there and you've never given your life to Christ, or you think you cannot be saved, or you think maybe God does not think about you, maybe because of the challenges and because of the lack of finances and even sometimes even the other basic needs. I want to remind you, God loves you the way you are. And if you would want a revival in your life, if you would want to experience the joy of the Lord, would you come to Christ today saying, whoever will believe in the name of Jesus, whoever shall call on this name shall be saved. I'm calling you to call on this name of the Lord, because it's not what you have done, as the song is saying. It is because of who he is. He is God over all. He remains to be God forever and ever. Therefore, would you come to Christ today and just accept, believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that he is Lord, and you shall be saved. Therefore, be encouraged today that God shows no partiality. He loves us the way we are. He loves us where we are. He accepts us the way we are, because he is God and he is God alone. Therefore, if you are there and you have never given your life to Christ, we are calling you to this a kingdom of God, where it is joy and peace and righteousness in the Holy Spirit, that you can accept Jesus. And if you're there and you've not given your life to Christ, may you just believe in your heart and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and your Savior. Just say after me, Lord Jesus, thank you today. You never showed any partiality to Cornelius, and neither to me. I believe in you. Come into my heart. Save me today. I stretch my hands to you. I stretch my faith to you. I'm a new creation. I believe you in the finished work of the cross. I'm born again. I'm redeemed. I'm justified. I am forgiven. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have said that prayer, believe that you have become born again. The old is gone and the new has come. The Bible says whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old is gone and the new has come. Therefore, you become a new creation, and forever you live to be of the family of God. Read your word. Read the Bible. That is the word of God every day. Make sure you pray. Join a Bible-believing church. Share your testimony with us. Share your testimony with them. And God will bless you and God will do you good. Therefore, I'm so happy that you've taken your time to listen to us, to subscribe to our channel. If you have not subscribed, we pray that you would subscribe as we continue taking this gospel farther and farther. We thank God for you. We love you so much, and may God bless you and do you good. Therefore, until next time, may God bless you. May God do you good. May his light shine upon you. May his favor be upon you. In the name of Jesus, we love you and God bless you so much. Until next time, God bless you. Amen and amen. And amen. Amen.